was the night before Christmas. Went on through the house. Not a creature was stirring. Not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care and hope that Saint Nicholas soon would be there. The children will nestle home, snug in their bed, while beauties and sugar plums danced in their heads.
Mother, tell your children not to walk my way. Tell your children not to hear my words, what they mean, what they say. Mother, mother, can you keep them in the dark for a while? Can you have a proper wedding world? Oh, mother, father, gonna take your daughter out tonight. Gonna show her my world. Oh, father, Lord, I'm bound to see her life. And if you wanna find hell with me, I can show you what it's like. Gotta be late, Lord, I'm bound to see her life. And if you wanna find hell with me, I can show you what it's
like. In a kerchief, her in my cap, had just settled down for a long winter's night. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave luster on midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eye would appear but a miniature sleigh and a tiny reindeer. The little old man, so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagle, his cousin they came. And he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, all Comet, all Cupid, all Nutter and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away. Dance away, dance away, oh. As the dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle mount through the sky, so up through the housetop the courses they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too. And they, in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around down the chimney, Saint Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his sack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his hair like wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye, a twist of his head, soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. I wasn't afraid anyway. Whatever. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his word, and filled all the stockings and turned with a jerk, and laying his finger aside on his nose, and giving a nod up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team he did whistle, and away they all flew like the down from a thistle. But I heard him exclaim ere he go out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a